In this video, we're going to investigate the oxidation of metals by acids and salts. So what we need to look at first is something called a displacement reaction. So a common redox reaction is a displacement reaction. And in a displacement reaction, one element replaces another in a compound. In doing so, the oxidation state of the metal changes. So we have oxidation happening and we also have reduction happening. So let's take a look at some experimental observations. We find that if we take solid iron or a solid strip of iron metal and place it in a copper sulfate solution, over time we're going to observe the products of copper metal plus an iron sulfate solution. But if we try the reverse, nothing happens. So if we take copper solid and we put it in a solution of copper sulfate, we observe no reaction. So the question we need to ask ourselves is, how can we tell whether a displacement reaction will take place? And there's something called the activity series that's going to allow us to do this. So the activity series which is table 4.5 is an experimentally determined list that indicates if a redox reaction will occur between metals in solution. And we can investigate this table to see and look at where on this list that metal occurs to see if a particular reaction will take place. So the key thing that we have to look at from this activity series or this table is that any metal on the list can be oxidized by the ions of elements below it. Now, if you turn to the activity series in your textbook, you will see that iron is higher than copper on the activity series. So therefore, iron solid is oxidized to iron 2 plus in the presence of copper. So, since iron's higher than copper on the activity series, this reaction will happen. Okay? On the flip side, if we compare copper, and since copper is lower than iron in the activity series, copper solid will not be oxidized to copper 2 plus in the presence of iron. And as a consequence, like we saw in our experimentally observed results here, no reaction is going to occur. So this activity series allows us to predict whether or not a reaction will occur when we look at metals being placed in aqueous solution, and also notice that hydrogen is also in that list. And hydrogen gas being oxidized to hydrogen ions in solution will allow us to look at some of the properties when acids react with certain metals. So this list can give us a lot of information if you know how to interpret it properly.